Hsin-I, how are you?
Oh, good. How are you?
Good. So tell me, how has it been like to be in New York City in the middle of the coronavirus pandemic?
So, as you know, everything is in sort of lockdown here, and you can only go out when you have to shop for grocery, when you have to see a doctor, and in my case, when I have to walk my dog, which is quite fortunate in this case. Because then I still get to go out and still go to the park. Cooper
How is Cooper doing?
is doing really well. He's very needy, so this is wonderful for him.
He gets to have you all the time.
Yes.
So what have you missed the most during the lockdown?
So I think what I miss the most is being on tour. I would have been on tour right now in Florida for 2 weeks for a 10 concert tour. And that's usually where I get my inspiration for practicing, performing, and stuff like that.
So, can you tell us a little bit about the classes that you've been having since the lockdown began? I know you've been teaching students as well.
All my teaching schedule is the same. It's just that everybody's online. I find that online teaching is not as efficient, so I try to give each student a little bit more time, just so we can still cover the same amount of materials.
Is that really hard doing it through the computer?
For me, it's not because I've been teaching online. I have students in Australia and then in Europe and stuff like that. So I've been doing it for a couple years now. So it's just the transition for the students who usually they're used to you being right next to them. So when you're from afar, they're sort of a little bit more relaxed.
Too relaxed.
Yeah. So sometimes you still need to remind them that this is a lesson and it's, you still need to try your best.
And now you, of course, your extended family is here in Taiwan. You must miss your family as well, yeah?
Yeah, but I know if they're in Taiwan, they're safe. So that's all that matters.
That's true. Now, you actually got married in Taiwan last August. And so, since getting married to your husband, you've been separate for a lot of this. Has that been hard, especially during the pandemic?
Yes, for sure. The last time we saw each other, it was in January. We were supposed to go on a vacation to Greece. Couple weeks ago, but because of the lockdown and everything, we decided not to travel just for the safety precaution. And yeah, so I probably won't see him till the summer, which really depends on the situation around the world.
Well, I hope the situation gets better there in New York City and you're able to see your partner and also your family as well. Now, I really enjoyed the quarantine music. So you've been posting almost every day a song on your Facebook page with the hashtag quarantine music. Tell me, why did you want to start doing that?
Well, so at first, since I was preparing for upcoming concerts, so I had a lot of repertoire ready to go. So at first, I just wanted to share music through the online platform. I wasn't thinking too much about it, but then
That's
Cooper
Cooper, huh?
wants to be in the
You want to
video.
bring him in?
He's lying over there.
He's usually lying underneath your feet when you're playing, right?
Yes, yeah, because he's very insecure.
Hmm.
So I was doing it at first just to share music, but then people started to comment on it, and then people enjoy it, and they find like sort of a safe space for them every day, a couple minutes just to reflect on how they feel and stuff like that. And then I was really inspired. So then I started to take requests and stuff like that, and then just to learn a piece every day. And it turns out to be a lot more work than I expected, but it's wonderful.
Tell me a little bit what people have said in the comments and how they've responded to quarantine music.
So I try to have different kind of music every day. So sometimes it's a little bit more meditative, and then sometimes it's like, you know, Bach, very like classical music stuff. So it hits different audience every day, and people usually resonate with the pieces that they probably heard when they were kids. Mm-hmm. So it reminds them of sort of family time most of the time. And since people can't really see each other right now, and I thought that was a very good reminder of what that feels like when you can spend time with your family and when we can still touch each other, you know?
Mm. Hugs, yeah.
Yeah.
So and what have the favorite songs been among the people who have commented?
One of the favorites so far is Xiao Tairan's Memories of Home, since I have a lot of Taiwanese friends on my Facebook, so they all resonate with that piece.
I certainly have loved it, so I want to thank you for that.
Thank you.
So now you are going to play a song for us today. Do you want to tell us what the song is, introduce it, and tell us who you'd like to dedicate it to?
Okay, so this piece is by Spanish composer Albéniz, and the piece is called Tango. As you know, that traveling is a big part of my life, just because of performance tours and stuff like that. So I thought it would be nice to transport everybody to Spain just for a couple minutes, and just imagine yourself being in Spain in the summer, super hot, and then you're enjoying a glass of wine outside in a plaza. So that's sort of setting the mood for the music, and then once you're with the music, then the music will take you through all the crazy stuff.
That sounds wonderful. The thought of traveling at this time, it's like, it's hard to even imagine anymore. And do you have anyone you'd like to dedicate it to?
Yes, I think I would like to dedicate this piece to all the health workers, people who are in the front line. Without them, we will be a huge mess right now.
Now, I know that people in New York City have also at times have been applauding for the medical workers.
Yes, every night at 7 p.m. So at 6:59, everybody will start cheering. And then right at 7, all the cars will honk. And then everybody will open their windows and then start clapping and shouting.
That must be really, like, quite an impressive thing to hear.
The first time I heard it, I was walking Cooper. And I was like, am I on the red carpet? What's happening? But then I read about it and I was like, oh, that's, you know, everybody's doing it just to show their appreciation. And I thought it was a very nice gesture and sort of feels like you're not in this alone. Everybody is in this together. And if we can stay together, we can go through this.
Well, best wishes to you and to your family near and far. Best wishes to Cooper, all of your listeners. And we hope that you stay safe during this pandemic. And now let's have a listen to the piece that you recorded for us.
All right, thank you.